Several agriculture organizations in Georgia were indicted for participating in human trafficking of foreign workers. Operation Blooming Onion was discovered in November of 2018 after agents received a tip. After their investigation, they discovered that several agriculture organizations registered under the agent Maria Leticia Patricio had been conspiring since 2015. They discovered that these organizations worked together to bring more than 100 foreign workers into the U.S. to exploit them and imprison them under inhumane conditions. They were able to do this by exploiting the H-2A visa program, which allows U.S. employers who meet specific regulatory requirements to bring foreign nationals to the U.S. to fill temporary agricultural jobs. Under this visa, employers are required to pay foreign workers just like they would U.S. citizens, which means that they're required to pay under the terms of contract, which is typically $10 to $12 per hour with pay stubs that accurately depict how much they got paid and how much was deducted. They're also required to pay up front or reimburse workers during their first work week for the fees associated with getting the visa, crossing the border, transportation, lodging, and food expenses. Under the law, they are prohibited from holding or confiscating immigration documents from their foreign workers. They are also prohibited from seeking or receiving payments from any kind of worker for recruiting them. It's basically saying that it is illegal for them to coerce their employees to give them money because they helped them get the H-2 visa. But unfortunately, foreign workers were unaware of their rights, which made them easy targets for exploitation. Workers were forced to dig onions with their bare hands. They were paid 20 cents for each bucket harvested. They were threatened with guns and violence to keep them in line. They were held in cramped, unsanitary quarters and fenced work camps with little or no food, limited plumbing, and without safe water. The conspirators are accused of SAing, kidnapping, and threatening or attempting to unalive some of the workers or their families. And in many cases, they sold or traded workers to other conspirators. And so far, we know of two workers that passed away due to the work conditions. The conspirators are alleged to have reaped more than $200 million from the illegal scheme. This large scheme took place over three different states, Florida, Georgia, and Texas. And the workers they were exploiting came from Mexico, Guatemala, Honduras, and other Central American countries. The conspirators required the workers to pay unlawful fees for transportation, food, and housing while they illegally withheld their travel and identification documents. And in 2019, when agents were closing in on the case, three of the conspirators attempted to intimidate and persuade witnesses to lie to the federal grand jury. They wanted them to deny any knowledge of the illegal activities of the Patricio organization. Since the organizations registered to Maria Leticia Patricio have been indicted, the organizations have been dissolving, meaning they're going out of business, as their last feeble attempt to avoid accountability. However, federal agents have done their work and they have the 24 names of the conspirators.
And all of the names have been made public.
What the Patricio organization did is modern slavery. They had these workers trapped in rural camps surrounded by electric fences. If they tried to escape, they would torture them and they would trade and sell them with other conspirators. And the worst part is that most of the conspirators were Latinos themselves.